It is time for more City of Heroes. We are about at the end, or reaching the end of the field agent Keith Nance arc. And after that we'll figure out what we're doing. So, last week we finished off Altline and began this arc where there are evil duplicates of our character running around causing mayhem, working with the freak show. We tracked them down to this area in Talos. Actually, Citadel seemed to have tracked down our double within Talos. So, we're gonna head there and defeat our evil twin. Eventually, with the aid of our good twin from another dimension. This is where your double has been working out of. Even though they managed to bring this base back to full operation, you'll see to it that they cause no more harm and clear your name completely. Something my evil self was supposed to do, or if... Oh, sorry. Run straight into some fridge. Wait, what? I don't think I did that fight very well. I'm gonna die. Shoot. I maybe should have paid a bit more attention. Was kind of mostly like seeing if the evil double would come back or something, you know. Let's do this seriously now. Come on. Let's not aggro this other group. Now what is he doing? Got them in. Now he's gonna rescue. Bit of a freak show. That's gonna be interesting. Difficulty, am I? do kind of wish the game didn't do that. There's three chiefs. There's 100% two mobs. easier than it was then. Is the game audio too high? Is that any better? It's sometimes difficult to find proper balance. I play this game with the sound off normally. I very, very often tend to play MMOs with zero sound on because... like, these guys shooting a bunch of machine guns by themselves kinda make a whole bunch of sound. Now, add that with two more pets, and then seven other players. It just starts to get to be a giant mess of audio clutter. Oh, jeez. Oh. I did done pulled the whole room, didn't I? Back then. And that's like not even counting the Incarnate Trials that are 24 people, and there's probably a bunch of masterminds there, so you have soldiers going off. Oh, are you in the EU, Wolfenbach? Because I hear it's ridiculously hot over there at the moment. I am sorry to hear that, Wolfenbach. Just drink plenty of liquids and do your best to stay cool. I always heard it was better to drink in smaller portions, just more through the day. That's how I was told to do it when it's hot out. I can't throw my other debuff without waking all those other guys up. Nope, I'll let you go back to sleep. No, you don't get to run away now. We're gonna pull. No, that guy has flashbang arrow on him, so we should be good. Thank you. By the way, for anyone who's not initiated in the game, the reason that... Oh, Jesus, no. They're all spread out now. The reason that a lot of these guys aren't attacking me is that this power here has a sleep effect to it. Which is why I'm not using some of my powers, is the icon, the power that's the icon next to it has a damage component, and damage will break sleeps. So... somewhat trying to use my control powers as best I can, but now everything's spread out, so I might just be screwed. They're probably not gonna follow me too well. This guy. Yeah, it was rather warm here last week. For the most part, it's been mild here in terms of summer. We had one particularly warm week last week, and that's about it. Other than that, it's just kind of in 50s to 70s. Why would you do that, Duff? Gather everybody up. Why did you do this to me, though? Thank you. There. Stupid freak show. Alright. You try to sleep well, Wolfenbuck. So, I don't know why, I don't know how the sounds of automatic mercenary fire will help you sleep. Oh, hey, we have a lieutenant in this group. Oh, okay. That'll work as a plan. Oh, there's another lieutenant. Yep. Go to sleep. Gonna go downstairs. He said everything. I probably should have, like, of course they run right up. Real problem here is that he is going. Alive? No? Huh. All right. Now that one revived. Some resistance. Finish this guy off. Chief will be back soon enough. He vanished, so that one's not gonna res. This one did though. This isn't too super tough if I do it correctly. Real secret is in before like my doppelganger. Is in a room, or is like plus four. Ice cream sounds like a great idea, Wolfbach. After I get done with the stream, I might like, I'm going out to get something to eat, so I might just stop and get a thing of ice cream myself. SpaceX going to the International Space Station. That's cool. I don't know what I think of Elon Musk personally. He needs to be, like, not be on Twitter, is the thing I think. But I will always respect the dude who's just like, hey, we're gonna try out all this different stuff to see what works. Now, I'm always glad to see like somebody trying to advance science and technology like that. There's my evil self. You're supposed to go to sleep. There, come on. Here's a Here's gonna be the real problem with a fateful showdown between two masterminds. It's mostly just gonna involve, like, arrows flying back and forth. While our pets shoot at each other. Able to defeat your evil double. This time, they couldn't teleport away. However, after a few moments, their entire body began to go into wild spasms before something inside them snapped, killing them instantly. You searched your mirror self only to find a set of order. Guns and Roses, you know what you must do. Ruin the reputation of the real you, then kill them before our plans are complete. We will move forward with the next part of this plan afterwards, with no signature. I have to go fly back to Nance here. Pick the difficulty back. Back up to plus 2. Hopefully the arc completion bonus XP for doing this will tick me up to level 24. And I get the second special ops summon. There we go. Guns and Boses, good to see you. Your other self arrived in time to save my superior, Jenny Adair. Your double is now waiting for further orders from us. I saw everything that happened in the base with your evil double. Agent Adair told me that this proves the theory correct, which means the case is in her hands now. You'll need to speak with her to finish SOGs. And he gives me her spirit as a contact, and we're gonna fly away from that because that's a large pack of so that my pets aggroed. Fly down and talk to Luminary, and I get a new power. Isn't disruption arrow, geez. Pick up assault. Fly over to the tech store. Hi, Freak Show. Didn't mean to bug you. Hi, I need a endurance reduction, please. Thank you. At least in two more levels, we pick up the commando.
That's not what I All right, let's go talk to Jen. Hi, Guns and Roses. Agent Vance may or may not have introduced you to me, but let's make it official, shall we? I'm Agent Jenny Adair. I believe I have you to thank for my timely rescue from your double. Let's get down to business. The events that transpired between you and your evil double have made me curious about a theory I have. The presence of fifth column technology only proved to further support my theory. I believe I know who is behind all of this. I believe we're dealing with a man named Anton Yeager, aka Protean. He's a shapeshifter who once fought against the Freedom Phalanx. He has also done some work with the Fifth Column in the past. Protean was believed to be killed by Manticore. I never believe that, of course, as I have a mind of my own. It's a comic book setting. Unless you found the body, they're not dead. Someone like Protean doesn't simply get shot with an arrow and die. I believe that he has been biding his time and is now on the move. He is notorious for trying to ruin the reputations of heroes in Paragon City. It looks like you were to be his next target. However, something still doesn't add up. Who exactly were you fighting all this time? Protean shouldn't be able to copy your powers, which means that he has help now. This is what concerns me. Our assignment is to find out everything we can about what Protean is doing here and put a stop to him once and for all. We'll begin our investigation once you're ready. Just so you know, you'll be working with someone you may be familiar with, your other self. So, there's two alternate selves going around. One is good, one is evil. Through the Looking Glass, Part 1, My Own Ally. Here's the situation, Guns N' Roses. We're aware that Protean has ties to the Fifth Column. He used these ties to support this evil double of yours. We're concerned about how deep his connections to the Fifth Column run. Has Protean become a major player within this group, or is he just using it? Your double has been doing some investigating on the side and discovered the location of a Fifth Column base here in Talos Island. That base should have records pertaining to the dealings that the Fifth Column have had with Protean. Excellent. We provided your double with a link to the earpiece that Agent Nance gave you. This should allow the two of you to communicate back and forth. So, we are going after a group called the Fifth Column, which are sort of Nazis. It's complicated. People call them Nazis for shorthand. I dislike calling them that because they're kind of run by an alien as old as planet Earth is, and wants to use Earth as a Nictus breeding, as an alien breeding ground. I'm not sure how well that gels with the idea of the Ubermensch and a master human race. It's kind of hard to have blonde hair and blue eyes when, like, your head's made of fire. Mechman was a little too far away. Oh jeez. Honestly, plus two might be a bit much. Alright, well. Let's do it like that, maybe. I think I'm pulling two groups. Alright, let's take it back down to plus one, two. That way. Alright, I'm trying to find a difficulty setting that is reasonable, where things don't, like, immediately die, but I don't instantly get murdered. I guess I was in two groups. Might have just had the difficulty ticked a little too high. It can be difficult to tell sometimes, especially with masterminds, what an appropriate level is. Jeez. Thank you. him while he's ceasing. Something like that was hoping. Alright, let's have everybody sacrifice their lives so I can retreat. Last storyline didn't give like any reward cards. Of course, the great thing is that I took the wrong path for this group, anyways, didn't I? Kill the mech man. Yeah, rip. That group is just kind of terribly positioned. Got an exploration badge. Good to see you made it back, Guns and Boozes. Your double reported in a few minutes ago. The files you found on Protean reveal some troubling news. He's beginning to work his way up the chain command in both the Fifth Column and the Council. Arkham Burkholder was once a member of the Fifth Column until the Council took over. Protean's actions mean he can only he's trying to break up the power of the Council, but why? Protean isn't someone who would throw his allegiance behind anyone besides himself. And he's trying to lure Burkholder away with clockwork plans? This can't be right at all. Give me a moment, Guns and Roses. I'm trying to make some calls. Speaking of which, I've hooked up my communicator to the earpiece you have. You can contact me whenever you wish. Through the Looking Glass, Part 2, a new issue. Alright, Guns and Roses, we've got a lead on Burkholder. It looks like the little turncoat arranged a meeting with the Fifth Column in a warehouse nearby. Our information shows that this might be the moment where Burkholder switches teams, but we're not going to allow that to happen. He has the information we need to track down Protean and put a stop to this once and for all. If we allow Burkholder into the Fifth Column, it could be the last time we see him for years. You and your double need to get to the warehouse and take down Burkholder. Good to know. I've spoken with your double already. He will go after Burkholder, and What you'll need to do is hack the fifth column database to get the information that they might have on this new clockwork technology. It's laughable, but if Burkholder is interested in it, then there must be something we're missing. And Burkholder will, of course, be an elite boss, so he might be in for a real fight. If I recall right, he's RNG melee, and that's... That with boss numbers is usually rough. But we'll go into the mission in a moment. I do need to go AFK for a few minutes here. Alright, sorry about that. I think that disruption arrow is level either 26 or 28. It's a long way off. Thank you. Burkholder is in here somewhere. You and your double have to root him out. Of course it ticks up to plus two. Just force. That's probably a really dumb idea now that I think about it. Move. I'd have been happier if you guys had stayed right where you're at. I Okay. Good job, guys, pulling that thing that I didn't need you to at all pull. Oh, crap. All by himself? Alright. Those two to sleep. Ice block him. Yeah. Okay, cool. That wasn't large enough to hit the two I put to sleep. Good. Let's go mud better than freak show. Seriously. rocket. In the end, once I hit 32, I'm not going to be able to do this, keep everyone put asleep strategy nearly as effectively, because all of my pets are going to have some AoE that'll break that sleep. Of course, by then, I'll have things like Oil Slick Arrow. The minions will be a little bit easier to handle. I want to clear the rest of the rooms here, at least this room. Rifle. Well, figure out what I can just in case Burkholder decides to play the I'm going to run into every single room in the instance game. Oh! Whoa, whoa. That was not at all what I wanted. Thank you. to explain the werewolf transformation, the Council and the Fifth Column both have ties with an alien race called the Nyx. They are alien beings that go from planet to planet consuming everything, sort of like locusts. Well, part of the process of Nyctai, or part of the Nyctai ability is to actually consume a host being, sort of like, I'm actually trying to think of a good example of that. Sort of like the... Oh... I forget what they're called. From Star Trek. The Lady Dax. The Dax Lady. Good to see you, Dax. I forget what those things are called. They sort of fuse with their host. Nyctus do that, except for instead of a willing host, they, use unwilling hosts. But you can take the shard of a dead Nyctus and implant it in a human, and it will either turn them into a vampire or a werewolf. So, when... Oh, my, other self and oh, he's downgraded to a boss. I can't CC him with one hit. Oh, Lord. That's not good. I thought I was just gonna be like, hey, Burkholder, get frozen. And I didn't. That didn't happen at all. Not quite the Borg. Closer to, the girl that Worf married in Deep Space Nine. They're not a hive mind, but the aliens have their own memories and personality. Oh, I'm gonna have to look it up. Krill. Humanoid species in that they are other, the symbiote experiences. The Trill? That's the name of the host. I don't know. Collectively, they're called the Trill. I guess they don't have separate names for the symbiote and the host. Okay. I thought there was a specific name for each part of that relationship. Anyways, we completed the mission here, and it is 7 o'clock, so this is where we're going to stop. But they made Archon Burkholder talk. We have the schematics from the clockwork, and they are from Pretoria. So Protean is working with the Praetorians to manipulate the fifth column and the council. And that is where we will leave things this week. Next week we continue exploring what Protean and the Praetorians' plans are. Thank you everybody who came by and watched, and have a good week. Oh, yes, the YouTube stuff. If you missed any part of this, you can catch it, the video on demand on YouTube, youtube.com/RyuPlaneswalker. You can actually find the whole leveling experience from 1 to where we are now. I did, Twinshot, the Midnighter Club, and Faultline all so far. Yeah. Bunch of actual, real storylines. So, thank you everybody who came by. If you watch on YouTube, do the like and the subscribe. If you're on Twitch, subscribe and hit the little notification thing. Everybody have a good week, and thank you for watching.
Alright, Tuesday, as I promised, I'm going to do a DC thing today, which will probably take a lot...
Sorry. Stupid auto plays.